So this is a video about trying to upgrade on a budget the stereo of my little smart Fortwo 450. It's a nice little smart that I've bought. It's although it's only done 40,000 miles, it's a 2005. So it does have this, what was in 2005, reasonably decent stereo with radio and CD player. But there's no Bluetooth and no auxiliary input. Now, I could just rip the whole thing out and replace it with just a sort of standard headset with those bits in, but this sort of fits specifically into this module, and so it would, they don't look, in my opinion, the greatest. So I thought if I could upgrade this somehow cheaply, somehow dial into it or break into it so that it can accept an auxiliary input, then I would like to give that a try, and I don't have much money, so I've bought from eBay France this funny little adapter thing. Let me get that out to show you. So it's just it's supposedly for the smart car, among many other cars. So basically, it's just got a headphones jack, a long lead, and a plug, which, if I'm lucky, will somehow fit into the back of this the basic smart unit. So I'm going to have a look at that. Okay, now you can get a special tool that you put in here, one each side, and twist it, and that lets you get it out, but I'm just trying it. I don't have such a tool, so I'm just trying it with a couple of skinny screwdrivers, pushing them in and just until they meet a bit of resistance, and then seeing if it'll just peel out. I think you've got to push it in a little bit, but not too far. Always work. Ah, that's it. Here we go. So once you've done that, actually underneath it's a pretty standard unit. Here we go. And right, we try and bring this up so you can see the back of this thing. Hold on. So there, can you see that? There's the standard connectors. But there's also this spare one that's not used. Now, the pattern there is not quite identical to the one on the back of this thing. But that's got a 323. And the back part, I can't see if you can see this or not. The back part of this, so this section here, is that 323 format. Yeah, now I think you can see it. 323. No, you can't see the very last one, but there's another over here. So I'm going to just try plugging it into that. Yeah, that went in quite nicely. There's a little peg just there on the end that lines up into a thing, and it went in with a bit of a click. I would feel a bit happier if it was filling the entire slot, but it doesn't. But anyway, I'm going to try that. Right, well, to be honest, I'm not quite sure what I did there, but it somehow seemed to figure out aux for itself, even though I wasn't in expert settings. I don't know if it made any difference, but I didn't have my phone plugged in at the time when the aux light suddenly appeared. So anyway, cheap and cheerful, 3.5mm plug into phone, a bit of music on the phone. Okay, that's coming through. I've turned it right up on the phone and now seem to be getting a reasonable level of volume in here. And actually, that's not a bad sound quality, I think. Right, so now I've established it will work, I've got to work out where I'm going to route the cables. I'm going to try and take this fella out. Saw a little trick of how to do that on YouTube. There's just like two clips down the edge. Two clips coming down the edge. That's one gone. And the other comes out. Maybe you can see that. It's just two little thingies. So what you're basically doing is pushing that down to let those come out. Right, that gives us a bit more. There's not much room in here. A bit more access. Oh, but that will let me get to the back of the thingy. There's something fair. Okay, so I'm quite pleased with that. Stereo's back in again. Because I'd taken the power off, I had to re-put the number in by pressing these four, the number of times of the four digits on the thing, and then TP to verify. But it came back on again. Slight relief. So I've just cut a tiny bit out there to give space for the lead to come out. So that shuts up reasonably neatly. And then I'm running it. Hang on, ignore that one. That's the USB power. So it just runs up here. It comes around the back of this unit so you can't even see it. And then it comes out here and it comes up to my SatNav, which is up here. So I'm quite happy with that. Right, so turn the fella on. This comes up check. Okay, sees orcs. And then we can hear it. I think it's purple rain. I could probably turn it up and... Actually, plenty of power there with the volume set to full on my phone. Might even turn my phone down a little bit. But I'm hoping that means I can not only have music on Spotify, but that actually the sound from the SatNav from my phone will come through on here too. And it's still, you know, looks pretty original. So I'm happy with that. Cheap and cheerful. I think that little unit was $6.50 and $6.50 for postage as well, or something from France. But actually, it's working and it's doing what I want to do. Would have been nicer with Bluetooth and all that, I suppose, but I think that was a bit more expensive. And I've got to run a cable from the thingy anyway up to it, so it's not the end of the world to have two cables plugged in. So anyway, happy with that. Hope that's been of interest. All the best.